हर घट तक है तेरी कहानी पग पग प्यारे
दंगल 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 दंगल
सूरज तेरा चढ़ता ढलता गर्दिश में करते हैं तारे
दंगल 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 दंगल
ग्रेट मॉर्निंग माय डियर फ्रेंड्स सो टुडे we will be discussing with these graphical presentations which I am showing you, and these graphical presentations are named as histogram and a frequency polygon. So I will be today discussing with learning outcome number D, and which tells me that how to prepare a histogram and what is the benefit of preparing a histogram and then a frequency polygon. What is to be taken into account in x-axis and what is to be taken into account in y-axis. So these figures we will be drawing today, and then we can easily, you know, analyze that where the data is more concentrated very easily. In the last lecture, that is in lecture number 3, today is lecture number 4. In lecture number 3, I have told you that there are 15 students who have got these marks, and these are the problems, you know. We can calculate average, we can calculate frequency distribution. Now, when I say frequency distribution, it does not satisfy me 100%. For that, I have to calculate relative frequency distribution. Then I have to calculate cumulative relative frequency distribution. But my dear friends, let me tell you, if I draw a frequency distribution schedule in a graphical presentation, within seconds I can analyze that where the data is more concentrated. So today I will be discussing with histograms, with frequency polygons. When I say frequency polygon, it is nothing but it is just like a brother and sister of a histogram. When we take the middle values, you know, of that interval, of the class interval which we have taken of the observations, and then prepare, you know, connect them with the straight lines. Then connect them with the straight lines. That will show me a frequency polygon. So we have to start with frequency polygon. Let us take out your registers, please. Please take out your registers because we have to start with lecture number 4. Great morning. I have written a quotation for you. Failure will never overtake me. A failure can never overtake me if my definition to succeed is strong enough. If my definition that I have to succeed this time in the first attempt in CFL level 1 examination, then failure has no meaning at all. So let me start with lecture number 4. In lecture number 4, we'll be discussing with learning outcome number D. And within that, 2 points, histogram and frequency polygon. Now, what is a histogram or what is a frequency polygon? It is nothing but it is a graphical presentation of frequency distribution. I repeat, it is a graphical presentation of frequency distribution. So I'm writing down first point. A histogram is the graphical presentation of absolute frequency distribution. I'm not calculating cumulative, not of relative, not of cumulative relative, only it is a graphical presentation of absolute frequency distribution. I repeat, a histogram is the graphical presentation of absolute frequency distribution. It is a bar chart. You have seen the figures, you have seen the images. It is a bar chart of continuous data. That is the intervals. Those intervals are continuous, from 0 to 20 marks, from 21 to 40 marks, from 41 to 60 marks, from 61 to... This is a continuous data. It is a bar chart of continuous data that has classified into a frequency distribution. Advantages. Now, what is the advantage of why we are drawing a histogram? Now, the point is, within seconds, you know, within a click of second, we can find out that where the data is more concentrated. So this is the main benefit of that. So my request to you will be, please prepare this histogram at least once. You know, you should be aware of that, that what is the, how we prepare a histogram. Please prepare it with your hands. X-axis, we take class interval, we take category, and in y-axis, we take frequencies. So please prepare it. These are the frequencies. So now, just see, here I can easily find out that in this interval, there is more concentration of the data. So within click of seconds, I can find out where there is more concentration. In x-axis, we take intervals. In y-axis, we will take frequencies. Now, this is all for histograms. Now, what is the meaning of frequency polygon? Now, my dear friends, in frequency polygon, no doubt we take interval in x-axis, y-axis, we take frequencies. But in x-axis, we actually take the middle values of the intervals. It means the middle values of the intervals, and then we connect these middle values with the straight lines. And when we connect with the straight lines, I will say it is named as a frequency polygon. So frequency polygon is a brother and sister of histogram. So let me write out one or two lines for frequency polygon. It plots the midpoints. I repeat, it plots the midpoints of each interval. For example, we have taken 0 to 20. So it plots 10. 21 to 40, it plots 30. 40 to 60, it plots 50. It means the middle value. Middle value means lower interval plus upper interval divided by 2. That middle point we can calculate. As in the school days, you know, the continuous series you have converted to discrete by taking lower interval plus higher interval divided by 2. So on the same basis, we calculate frequency polygon. So it is a graphical presentation again. But it takes the middle value of the intervals of the categories and the frequencies, as it is the absolute frequencies, and then connect these points with straight lines. So that is named as a frequency polygon. It plots the midpoints of each interval on the horizontal axis and absolute frequency for that interval on the vertical axis, and connects the midpoint with straight lines. So that is named a frequency polygon. Can be tested in the examination, but my request to you will be, please at least have a look, you know, and with the help of frequency polygon or with the help of histogram, we can easily look that where the data is more concentrated. My dear friends, my request to you will be, at least for once, prepare a frequency polygon by your hand, because it will, you know, indirectly go in your mind. X-axis, we will be taking the midpoints of the class interval, and in y-axis, we are taking the frequencies, and then those midpoints are joined together with the help of straight lines, and that is named as a frequency polygon. Please prepare it. I am waiting for you. Please prepare it. The graphical presentation of histogram and the graphical presentation of frequency polygon. So we have discussed lecture number 4. Now the point is, we have covered 4 lectures up till this point. Now what is there in all these 4 lectures? First point is, in the lecture number 1, I have discussed that what are the different types of statistics, you know, descriptive statistics and inferential statistics, then population and mean, population and sample, then different types of scales, nominal, ordinal, interval and ratio. Then in the next lecture, I discuss about parameter and sample statistics. In the third lecture, I discuss that why there is a need of frequency distribution and how to prepare it, what are the steps for that, and why we prepare relative distribution, and what is the meaning of cumulative relative distribution. And in today's lecture, that frequency distribution with absolute frequencies, if graphically prepared, then they are named as histogram, and if I connect the middle values, then that is named as frequency polygon. And the use of histogram and frequency polygon is, within a click of seconds, I can easily find out that where more observations are concentrated. So hope you are enjoying it. Be happy, be jolly, be cheerful.